Welcome back to the Laylight Thinks Out Loud show, starring me, Laylight, guest starring Sausages, and our friend with a fork here. So, last time I made new observations, at least. I don't know if they're going to be relevant observations to this particular puzzle, but there were new observations anyway, and that at least makes me feel like I'm making progress on this. Even if it's slow, even if it's painful. Nevertheless, science is often slow and painful. So, with that wonderfully joyous thought, let us go ahead and see if we can get anything new done and exciting. So we experimented a lot with our movement options. That's really what's the soul of this whole puzzle, is your movement options. They start out restricted in not even particularly strict ways, just really loose ways. It's the thing is that just everything is kind of tied together. All your log rolling is dependent upon the position of all three of your sausages. Your ability to see do away with the northwest passage is conditional upon either you not having your fork at the time, which is potentially correctable, or having a sausage in the northwest corner, which is, again, potentially correctable. But both of those are in very unclear ways. And your ability to walk around with the grills and with everything else in here, it's all connected in very loose ways, but still very concrete ways, almost. It's very unlike all the other puzzles, because in those ways, the zones in which you could go were often a lot less restricted. I mean, they were clearly delineated, I guess is what I'm trying to say. It's very clear in which what your movement options were. It's just that you were trying to manipulate the sausages or manipulate the grills or some other part of the puzzle was, unclear, and you were trying to figure out some kind of execution difficulty based around that. But here, execution difficulty ties into everything. You've seen how much trouble I've had even just trying to put together intermediate configurations which might or might not be useful for some larger goal at hand. So everything is difficult here. Everything from moving around to trying to visualize what might be good to trying to just figure out the effects of the five different ladders we have in this puzzle. I think most of the other puzzles we've had, you've only had to worry about one or two at a time. But here you have five ladders, which all might be relevant at any one particular point. And of course, the sausage count is at three, which is, of course, the magic number. You can do quite a lot of puzzles in this game with one or two sausages, but with three, you start getting into weird territory. Now, I guess one other thing I haven't really tried yet is trying to rotate one of my sausages. If I turn both of the vertical ones horizontal, then that might make my life easier. I'm not sure how yet, but it could. Turning the horizontal one vertical doesn't seem to be as helpful, mostly because vertical seems to be the harder one to cook in this particular case. But, again, I digress. Now, horizontal does not seem to be as useful for disarming this this mechanism as vertical. We've only found one sausage-based way of doing that so far. We experimented much, much earlier with having a sausage being stabbed to try and get past this little point here by a strafing move, but you just wind up at a different impasse. Even if I were to correct that via having some form of reaching mechanism, it's still all very iffy. It's this one square of water here in the middle. That one is responsible for a lot of the pain and hardship of this particular puzzle. Now, even if I do something like this, it's not particularly helpful, but I want to play it out anyway. That's really what I've been reduced to, is seeing things that are impossible, but trying them anyway. I mean, I can get a little bit further doing this, but not much further. Does not really seem to help. I don't know if there's any way in which stacking a horizontal sausage on top of that could help, but I'll try it anyway. I will try that anyway. Yeah, so you have room for all kinds of amazingly creative, amazingly weird and strange ideas in this particular map. And most of them will not help. Yeah, so now I can do that. And do that, and that doesn't seem to really help. If I could get it one more, if I could get that horizontal sausage one square further upwards, perhaps. But... yeah, there's nothing going on here. Sure was neat, though. So, I guess that's really just the question, is do I just try more weird stuff like that, or do I try and work with just the basic log rolling I've been doing with the, well, I say basic, but something I've been trying since several episodes ago, just dumping three sausages on the east side and see if I can log roll with the horizontal sausage and see if I can get anything done with that. I've tried rotating the thing on top of my head, but I'm not sure to what extent that would help. But, because, like, that's only relevant if there's something on the upper layer that I would want to push, and so far I haven't really managed to build any structures that are taller than two at the moment. If I could build a three-tall structure, then, like, if I could have a two-tall structure, like, if I actually just managed to stack these two vertical sausages on top of one another, then theoretically it could be possible that having the third one on top of my head could potentially be relevant, as far as maybe pushing a sausage on top of one of these pillars. But I still don't see how that helps. It's all about the access restrictions. Yeah, and there's no yellow doors in this game. There's no doors, there's no switches, there's no, you know, there's no switches, there's no bridges, there's no trapdoors, there's no, nothing explicitly keeping you from doing the things you want to do, except for the terrain and the sausages and, the grills and the cooked status of the sausages themselves. And I guess whether you're holding onto your fork or not. There's a lot of state information in this game. There's very few direct ways of manipulating it, though. Everything is indirect in this game. Like, we haven't even dipped our toes into the terrors of things like turning on and off grills, or even, like, moving grills around. That would be, yeah, that would be terrifying. Yeah, so see, okay, so here's the other thing I was thinking about, is, like, if I drop this into the middle part, there's no way I can roll this, that way, and then back up and then all the way over here. That doesn't work, because that would just cook it too much. But if I dismount onto, like, if I do a once downwards like that, and I dismount onto the left side, there's still nowhere to go, even if I'm top of that sausage. So, I mean, that's really the thing, is, like, do I engage with the log rolling, or do I just try and figure out other ways of doing extremely weird things that would not be apparent at first, but are, potentially helpful? So far, I've not had very good success with those things. I don't think I worked with this one very much. Let's try this configuration now. If I'm gonna be doing the log rolling, I might as well at least do something... something that I haven't done in a while. Right, so if I go over there, then that's okay-ish. It just means that I have to, move this sausage all the way over to the right, which I can do. I can do that. I mean, actually, does that help much? Well, now I can't do anything, so that would involve... And if I push it over on the left, yeah, that's the reason I don't do this. It's because if I push it on the left, then it immediately goes all the way down to the floor. That's right, floor. So I can do that, which, I mean, I could already do that. Okay, that's interesting. That's a move I wasn't able to do before, but it doesn't seem particularly helpful, because... I could drop that off, but, like, even if I do that, then, like, you know, even if I survive this, I've got a cooked sausage instead of a burned sausage. What exactly am I going to do in this particular case? Nothing? I'm going to say nothing. So that leaves the other two configurations, which I basically expounded upon the other time, which were, both sausages on the bottom, or the left one on the bottom and the right one on the top. Right? Well, left bot, yeah, actually, no, it does work the other way, as long as you've got, enough room. Like, you can do it, this way. Like, this does work as long as you don't push it all the way the maximum for maximum distance, because you do have to be able to push the sausage one square further over to the right. Like, this does work. Where if I have the horizontal sausage up here, then I push that over to its maximum distance. This allows for perfectly fine log rolling, and is in fact what I've actually been experimenting with. Wait, did I get that backwards? I think I got that backwards. No, I didn't have it backwards. It's just that this was just what I was experimenting with earlier, and... Okay, again, that's interesting, but probably not relevant. How did I even wind up over there in the first place? Oh, I walked, of course. That's what you do. Yeah, and this goes back to this zone. I feel like I'm close. I feel like I've been within striking distance of the solution the whole time. It's just that there's some other step I'm missing. Whether it's good timing with this, or something to do with the ladders, I don't think there's any mechanics I'm overlooking. I think I've already found everything that's relevant to the solution. There's just some sort of ordering that I'm not finding quite yet. Quite yet. So, either I need to be able to clean off this ladder, and then, well, I need to be able to do something with this. Yeah, because fundamentally the whole thing that's driving this whole thing is that, like, when you put a vertical sausage on here, it's hard to get it back, A, for one, and B, at some point or another, the vertical sausages have to be transported in such a way that breaks parity. Whether it's by stabbing, whether it's by direct carrying, in such a way that you just translate them over a column without actually rolling them. One of those things has to happen in order to, do that with. And... I don't know, there's just a limited number of places in which you can actually do that because of the terrain. So So, I don't think I actually did this yet. I'm still struggling to see how that's gonna help, but it's worth a try, I suppose. But yeah, this is just a different way of, like, a different flavor of expressing the same problem. I mean, I can get back over here, but then there's nowhere to go. Look, I'm not proud. I will look up a hint for this puzzle if I really have to, but I feel like I'm just not done with it yet, somehow. Like, there's just something I haven't... Like, there's just something else I have to do that I just haven't yet. And it will make sense in hindsight, I'm pretty sure. Like, the solution will be such a thing that just makes sense given the way the terrain is laid out, given all the other things I've observed so far. It will satisfy in the, like, in the academic sense, but I'm just not quite sure yet. So let's review. There's... The vertical sausages have to go on the grills at some point or another. With all the noodling around I've been doing, with putting them in individual intermediate spots, getting, like, our friend over to new spots. Sure, that's all well and good, but sooner or later, a vertical sausage has to get on the grills. There's no getting around that. In order to get them off the grills, you have to either push them off, which would be, like I could push it over this way. You can retrieve them, unhook them. We've shown how to do that. And then put them back on the grills. Or alternatively, you can, if you push them left, that doesn't really seem to help anyway, because it seems as though if you push them left off the grills, they kind of just have to wind up going to the right eventually anyway. I have not yet figured out, with all of my experimenting, with all of my really trying to push the boundaries of everything, I have not found anything productive to do with a sausage that's over on this west wall over here, other than push it right back onto the grills. So that seems to imply, at the very least, at some point in the solution, our friend has to get over onto the east side in order to do further work with a sausage. I think that's been at least an operating assumption I've been kind of running on with for a lot of these partial solution attempts, but I think I should just state that out loud, just to be absolutely sure. I am pretty darn sure at this point, with everything that I've been doing so far, that there is just no way you can solve this puzzle while only staying on the west side of it, without engaging with the east side at all. So, I have to get out of the left, out of the middle, and go over to the right, and stand on the very bottom of this area at least once. I think it's safe to say that at this point, because I found multiple different ways of doing that. But at the very least, like, that has to get done at some point. Now, the ways you can do that are as follows. You can either stuff up the Northwest Passage in such a way as to temporarily disable that, or you can, like, go off and, like, land on the north somehow. Or you have to do this complicated song and dance where you, like, get a sausage, like, have our hero climb up this east ladder, and then clear off the east ladder, and then go all the way down the east ladder. So far, we've found multiple ways of doing that. The only way we have found so far to do that, is this set of solutions where you put a sausage here at some point. That allows multiple way access. That allows you to basically go to the east side whenever you want. Sit down, be on ground level, walk around, enjoy your freedom of the wild. Enjoy this amazing 4x4 corner over here, 4-tile corner. You know, breathe the fresh air of wintertime. And also, incidentally, rescue this sausage. Now, notice that I haven't actually done anything with that upper sausage yet. It's still there. That's interesting, actually. So, for example, I could actually, like, push this off the east side like I've been thinking about this whole time. I mean, I don't think it'll be help yet, but it seems relevant, so I'll just go ahead and experiment with that now. Like, that enables log rolling on the very edge of things. I mean, again, I don't know how this will help, but it is a thing I can do. In fact, what I can do instead is I could do a little variation on that. So it's if instead of placing that there, I could instead put this here, align it with the ladder. Then, do the variation where I push this off over here, log roll this backwards, then log roll it forwards, and wait, I tried that already. No, that doesn't work. That does not work because there's nowhere for me to dismount after that. That's right. And other solutions would involve, like, if I had another sausage over to the east of me at this point, like if I had a third one, then I would dismount over to the right and then log roll that vertical sausage over to the left a little bit. This horizontal one is uncooked. But I would log roll enough to bring that vertical one in alignment with this, and then I think it would be possible to unjam the ladder. But I think all of that is predicated upon like, being able to use the Northwest Passage. Now, I found multiple ways of using the Northwest Passage, and one of them is having lost my fork. I have not yet found a way to deposit my fork on the eastmost column, but it is possible to do that if I do all those things I did earlier, which is, namely, well, let's do them again. I'm just gonna actually show this process, because I may have other, steps I want to do after that. So yeah, I go ahead and do that. I may not even need to cook that half full. Like, I might not even need to cook that fully yet, so I guess I'll just do this for now. I can cook the other half of this sausage later if I want to, but for now, I'll just do it like this. Wait, actually, no. Yeah, that's the problem. Like, I can't get the sausage, I can't get the horizontal sausage to be resting on top of this with the east side. Like, I can't do that. Like, I can't deposit my fork onto this east side of this cliff, until, like, unless I have some other kind of bridging mechanism. Because if I push these, the top sausage becomes, I can start log rolling it. If I push this over here, or if I push this down here. But in neither of those cases can I actually let go of my fork. And, like, what I'm thinking is, like, I don't know, the fork will be facing the wrong way if I do that, though. Because what I was thinking was, if I temporarily get rid of the fork and, like, do some kind of other thing like that, then it's possible that I could, what would that involve, though? I'm using the fork to do that. So if I don't have the fork, this is my only pushing move. And I don't see how you would build a, I don't think you can build a set of mechanisms that would actually, remotely untrap the, untrap the ladder. I think the sausages are just physically not shaped the right way. Because, if I had a vertical at that point... No, see, it would be a horizontal, because I'd drop it. So there would be a horizontal, and it would be one, the square that's at the bottom of the ladder, and then one square over. So both of the vertical sausages, would have to be placed in a staggered pattern. An S-shaped pattern. One would have to be facing vertically on the grills, so I'd be stepping east without my fork, pushing it east. The other one would be staggered one square above it, and even that wouldn't actually clear it up, because then that would mean that the second vertical sausage would then become the one that's at the ladder. So I'd have to pick up my fork in order to disengage that, but with my fork I would be unable to go back up through here. So, this puzzle is full of little tiny logical contradictions just like that one. And this is, of course, leaving aside the whole, how do I get this cooked problem. I guess I'll experiment a little bit more with the whole losing my fork on the west side of the cliff and then, leaving it on the north side problem, but I still haven't figured out how to actually solve the issue where... that vertical sausage with my forks gets stuck in it, still winds up trapped on the north side, and I can't really bring it back to the grills at that point, because there's just no way of getting around it. And there's no way of remotely pushing it, of course, because, just because of the shape of it. I'm wondering briefly if I can actually stab it facing this way, but that actually creates more problems than it solves, I think. And I don't see any obvious way of stabbing facing south anyway. That would be a really tall order, I think. Managing a vertical, a downwards vertical stab into a vertical sausage on this puzzle. Just because all the bracing spots are to the north. Okay, so, yeah, so that's really just the problem, is, even though I can say definite things about what the solution involves, I kind of run out of definite things to say at some point, and it still kind of devolves into this kind of trial and error eventually anyhow. Because even though I can say things that I think ought to be true, eventually at some point I start saying things that would be nice if they were true, instead of, things that are actually true. And it's important to actually pay attention to those. So let's see, I can fully cook this, I can fully cook the horizontal. I haven't had any problems doing that, actually. Those are all actually pretty straightforward. Once I have this two-way passage established, it's just that you need extremely specific mechanisms in place in order to still work with this. I have not yet figured out a way of dropping this that seems constructive. The only place I have found to drop this so far have been the two, of the little vertical the little ladder area that's to the northeast. The only places I've found to drop this have been on the left and middle parts of that vertical ladder area, both of which are awkward in their own ways. middle part seems immediately wrong because there's just no way to climb up the ladder without immediately grabbing my fork back and then having it stuck to my hands again. If I put it on the left side, then there's no way of getting around it that doesn't involve pushing it to the left and then putting it in an extremely inconvenient spot on the north side. And I have not yet figured out any way of getting around that. You can either leave it where it is and leave the west part undone, or you can do that. So even though I could cook like 3/4 of this sausage, I still haven't figured out how to cook like the last part of it. So I can imagine a case where I do figure that out, and then I have like all 3 of the sausages cooked, but then I would have like all 3 of the sausages cooked, but I wouldn't have my fork. And because this start symbol like has like the little spiral sign or the at sign or whatever you want to call it, and a fork, and you have to be facing the correct way in order to activate it, I kind of get the idea that I'll have all the sausages cooked in such a case, but I won't actually be able to leave the level because I won't have my fork on me. So I won't like eat the sausages and like teleport the fork back to my hands. I'm pretty sure that's not how this works. I think I'd have to actually be holding the fork in order to do that. And that would involve, picking back up the fork and making it back over here with the sausage still in my fork. That I'm pretty sure is reasonable. I think I've actually done that before, earlier. But I don't think it would work if I were disforked. So what does that leave us? Well, it leaves us with the really tricky to deal with situation where I have a one-way passage over here. So that gives me an extremely limited amount of ways in which I can work with this. Now, maybe there's another way of disarming this. Like, I've only found 2 so far. Being disarmed, disforked, and having the sausage in that position. But maybe there's another. Maybe there is another way of enabling two-way passage that I just haven't thought about yet. The horizontal sausage will be of no help, because this entire area is a moat. Like, not just the area in between the north bit and the grills, but all 4 of these squares are water. So if I put a horizontal sausage in this position, it will just fall into the drink, and there won't be anything to do about that. The other ways I've found have been log rolling over to the east side. And there's no other way I can put a sausage in position that helps. Because the ladder is placed on this side, having the sausage not be fully out of there doesn't help. It has to be shoved all the way in here to be of any help with the Northwest Passage. So at that point, unless it's a fully cooked sausage, or not even like a fully cooked sausage, just a half-cooked sausage, like, having a half-cooked sausage in this area already, it's not of much help to me. On the other hand, once sausages go over to the east side, they have a tendency to stay there. For all my experimentation, all my partial solutions, I have not yet on any occasion, managed to get a sausage from the east side back over to the west side. I have not done that on any of my runs at all yet. Is it possible? Who knows? Seems unlikely. The pillars kind of prevent casual westward movement. I don't see any way to elevate these without the help of my fork. Again, we've had a very limited number of ways in which we can actually stab these things in such a way that they help. Although I do spot that I could potentially carry a sausage over the ladder if, like, somehow I started with ladder access. So let's just do this, I guess. Just for the sake of argument, so I can actually demonstrate these steps. Like, let's say that I'm on the east side, and I have access to a vertical sausage. If I do this particular stab, if I do this one, it is possible to walk up this ladder, go over here, go down, and unstab. That is possible. I don't know to what extent that helps, though. What it means is I can do a vertical push like that, but that's not very far. I'm trying to just kind of visualize what way having a horizontal sausage around would help at this point, but I'm not sure it really does much. Because that still doesn't solve the problem that, of course, in this particular case, that I had to jam a sausage into this part in the first place. But, like, assuming that I didn't have to do that somehow, which I guess would involve log rolling, then... Well, then we kind of run into the same kinds of problems. So let's just leave that third sausage over there on the west side for now. Let's not even put it into that position yet. Let's just do... Well, not that, I guess. Something that lines me up with the ladder, I guess. And we'll even lose our fork, too. Sure, why not? Well, that's a problem. Yeah, I would love to figure out some way of, putting the fork on that east pillar to just lose it temporarily and still be able to wander around with it, lost. Well, here's a thought. I haven't done this part yet. I don't know how I would lose my fork in this case, because in order to do that, I'd have to... There's a very specific way in which I could do that. Lose my fork on top of this cliff. I could do that. It's going to involve jamming this in again, which I'm still kind of... I'm getting a little bit more skeptical about viewing that as the first thing I do. I'm kind of thinking that might be a thing I do later, but I don't think I do that at the start of this solution. But nevertheless, it is very handy to just be able to experiment with things on the east side. The problem I am immediately seeing, though, is that I can't log roll while facing a direction perpendicular to the direction in which I do the log roll. Like, I'll just show you. I'll go through the whole steps anyway, even though I think my idea doesn't work. I'll just at least show what I'm thinking about, because that's the whole point of this whole endeavor. It'd be something like that. Yeah, not any further, just that. Then I go over here. This is a one-way passage still. I guess... Theoretically, hypothetically speaking. But yeah, there's no way of log rolling in this particular scenario unless I am like strafing for some reason. If I am, then I can log roll vertically, and that would let me drop my fork on the northeast side of this cliff down here. Problem is, I can't do that unless I have my fork in a sausage, and that seems very unlikely at this point. Wait a second. Hold the phone. Let's combine multiple ideas again. We found that there's no way of dropping my fork onto the east side of the cliff, if the fork is the only thing I'm holding. However, let's even do this. Let's half cook the sausage that winds up in the this side. Yeah, we'll do that because that will be. I haven't figured out how to do that yet. If I had figured out how to do that, then this would be a very different puzzle. But we'll get there. No, we'll do that part later. That's all fine. Yeah, that's all fine. So far, so good. So as before, we'll put this over here, and I think I figured out a way to unstick my fork, but without the access point be on the east side of the cliff, as I wanted. And it involves having that west sausage stabbed. So again, I'm going to combine two halves of two different solutions, but in this case, it's a different, yet another different idea. So we're going to do this part as we did before. Well, except it's going to be down, here? Yeah, down there. Where am I going to want this exactly? I guess one further down ought to be good. Yeah, one further down. You'll see why. Just give me a second here. In fact, you probably already do see why. Alright. And we're gonna have to pre-place this, but that's alright. We'll pre-place this. So then we'll stab the west sausage as soon as we're done here. Man, this is the most complicated plan I have had to put together in this game so far. And I am loving it. I am loving every minute of this, but this, just compare this briefly to all the other, wait, that's not right. Okay, so, not quite, but, you get what I'm trying to do. Just, let's redo that, just, well, we don't have to go that far. Do not have to go that far, just leave that there for now. We'll shove that one more up. We'll prop the fork using the cliff, but using the extended reach of the sausage. Right, because with our fork and the sausage, it's a 2-tall reach, not a 3-tall reach, of course. So it only extends our reach by 1 tile, not by 2. Yeah, that's where I went wrong. That was the miscalculation I made, but it's easily fixed. So we'll do this, we'll partially cook this sausage because that seems like a good idea at this particular juncture. Yep, do that. We can even shove that over as part of this step, that's fine. Yeah, there. That's it. Now, I've lost my fork, but it's at a spot where I'm on the east cliff now. And it makes a lovely metallic sound. Okay, excellent. The problem with this particular plan, though, is it still leaves me with the problem that this particular ladder is now inaccessible. So even though I've done excellent things with this, I'm still not done. I've done something that is suggestive of progress, but does not in itself actually constitute progress. Well, hold up. If I could... Man, if I could just figure out a way to... like, get this... this vertical sausage that's below me at the moment, one square over further to the east, I might actually have something here. I might actually be getting close, but I can't do that. So, like, if I could dismount, go over here, go onto this pillar, go onto the other sausage, I don't know what that would do for me. I really don't know what that would do for me, but it would be cool. Man, that's so cool. How is that not the solution? Like, extending my reach like that, losing my fork, gaining the ability to go back over to the west, which seems kind of irrelevant now that I have all three sausages over on the east side anyway. I can't just walk across the grills. I can't jump. This isn't a game where you jump. But But there's just no getting around the fact that to unclog a sausage from the ladder, you need a very specific setup, as we saw in that other puzzle way back when, with a much simpler ladder unclogging problem. It's rough, but this is not the right way. This is not the way. Alright. I think I'm gonna take a break again. I think I'm just gonna come back to this some other day. And I might have to look up a hint for this one. It's bothering me. I've tried many things that don't work. I have looked into the future a little bit, and I have decided that I think it's just going to be a lot of stumbling around at this point. If I don't at least get some kind of hint as to where to go, because I've tried many things which are neat, are very creative, but are not correct, and there's just some level of there's just something that's in my blind spot as far as figuring out something super helpful that fixes a lot of these issues. And if it's unclogging the ladder, that might be one thing. If it's some mechanic I'm overlooking, that's fine. But there's just something I'm not quite putting together. It's just some puzzle piece that just doesn't quite fit into what I'm thinking about. Or just something I'm overlooking. It's possible. There's just so many things to see in this puzzle. It'd be very easy to not see one thing.